What's going on, guys? So in this video, we are going to discuss a very, very commonly asked question. And it's really a personal question related to the type of floor plan that might be best for each individual family or RV lifestyle. So I'm going to attempt to go over some of the most common floor plans in this video. So hang tight, I'll be right back. So I'm going to use this amazing footage from my latest trip to Utah, where I was able to film and test drive the new Frontier as a backdrop for this rant video, because it was just absolutely breathtaking, and I think it makes for a very, very enjoyable background to view. I'm also going to be using the floor plans from Grand Design and their Solitude lineup for this video, since they have several floor plans, and they actually have floor plans that cover each type of floor plan that you're most likely going to see if you visit an RV dealership lot, even if it's not a Grand Design product. So regardless of it being a Jayco or a Heartland or a Coachman, they all will generally fall into the categories that I'm going to be showing you here. And again, the main point of this video is for me to give you my opinion on the type of floor plan that you might be interested in and the perks, as well as some of the things that you might not like about certain floor plans, just based purely on the floor plan itself, not any specific manufacturer, not how they do it, but again, just on the floor plan designs themselves. So let's go ahead and kick this thing off and get started with the first floor plan. And kind of as a disclaimer, keep in mind that manufacturers are always trying to modify, tweak, and evolve their floor plans so they are, I guess, more cross-compatible with different types of floor plans. So even though I go over specific types of floor plans, just keep in mind, you may be looking at a specific one or maybe even have one that bridges some of the pros and cons of multiple different types of floor plan designs. Anyways, the first floor plan we're going to talk about is by far the most popular and the highest selling type of floor plan you see in a fifth wheel, and that's going to be the rear living room model. And here are what I believe the primary perks of a rear living room model are. Usually, they're going to have the most windows and the most natural light, and they're going to have the largest windows because the windows will typically wrap almost completely around the rear living room section. In some cases, you may even have one behind the TV and a televator system that can drop out of the way so you can actually watch it. And then you're also going to have a lot of windows around the dinette as well as on the ends of the slides. So if you're looking for the most, I guess, natural lit up living room entertaining area, typically a rear living room model is going to be what's going to provide that to you. Also, it's usually going to have the best kind of combination of dining and entertainment area in one space. What I mean by that is if you have a lot of people inside your RV and you have folks sitting in the living room area, typically you can still have a conversation and kind of hang out with the folks who are in the dinette area. And the other floor plans don't accomplish that quite as well. Also, depending on the manufacturer and how they design their roof line, you could have taller ceiling heights in the kitchen and living room, as well as taller ceilings in the slide outs themselves in those areas, simply because they can have more room to put those in if they have a full profile, flat, straight roof going all the way across the top. Now, if it dips down in the back, you're probably going to have some, you know, areas where it might not be as tall, but they generally will have the option, at least with those floor plans, to have a taller kitchen and living room area. So you could even have a full-size residential style sofa in the back that can convert into a bed. So other floor plans might be limited only because of how you can actually place a sofa, but rear living room floor plans typically give you the width you need to put a full-size residential sofa in place. Also, you'll have probably the most cohesive floor plan. And what I mean by that is a floor plan that combines your kitchen, your dinette, and your living area into one space, so you have the ability to kind of communicate and co-mingle in that entire area as opposed to having all these separate spaces in your RV. You'll also likely have the largest front basement storage, since the longer bath deck that supports the bathroom and the typically give the RV manufacturer more space to actually give back to you in terms of storage space underneath that area. So yeah, large basement storage is a big one. Also, another one is it's easier for the manufacturer to balance the weight of the RV internally by placing the tanks and other components more towards the center, since the living room area itself generally won't have any type of plumbing going to it. And then the front bedroom warm area, it won't either unless you have like a washing machine or, you know, prep for that. But most of your tanks, most of your heavier appliances will be placed more towards the center above the axles, which again gives the manufacturer a little bit more flexibility on how to actually manage weight and balance on your specific unit. The longer models can sometimes accommodate a half bath right off of the kitchen area. So you can have a full bath more towards the front, then a half bath kind of in the center towards the kitchen area. So you have some flexibility, but that's typically going to be on your longer models. Now, here are some things that you may not like about a rear living room floor plan, and this isn't always going to be the case. Different floor plans will have different ways of addressing this. If it's a front bathroom model, you could have a very large front bathroom, so just keep that in mind. But typically, most of your floor plans will have a smaller bathroom since it's going to be sandwiched between the kitchen and the actual bedroom on the elevated bath deck area. But again, there are several floor plans that give you this huge front bathroom, and they even will give you a half bath off of the kitchen, like I mentioned earlier. So that's not necessarily a con. You just have to find a floor plan that gives you what you're looking for in terms of that, if a rear living room is specifically what you're looking for. You'll typically have lower ceiling heights in both the bedroom and bathroom simply because they'll generally be on the elevated front bath deck area. So it's going to limit how tall you can go. And I think about 6'5" is about the highest I've seen in those spaces. And sometimes the front bedroom might actually feel cramped, especially if you equip it with a king size bed. And that's typically because of how it has to be set up in that type of floor plan. But again, some floor plans vary and some have really, really great space up front. But a lot of them, that's generally what you'll see in terms of challenges. All right, so for our next floor plan, let's talk about front living room fifth wheels. Typically, they're going to have the largest bedroom and bathroom options with the tallest ceilings since they're generally placed in the back of the fifth wheel, and they have the most floor space that isn't going to be obstructed by stairs or anything like that. They're often going to have the most sleeping space in the living room area as well, since the living room will usually have opposing slides with either small sofas or love seats that can convert into beds. Sometimes they're going to have a huge basement storage area towards the rear, basically an elevated bedroom deck that has storage underneath it. And that really can come in handy, but we're going to talk about some things that you want to be careful of if you have a model like that. Oftentimes they'll have a very large kitchen towards the center. It might have more of a smaller island design, but it will typically be off of the living room and isolated from the living room by some type of a structure. Generally, that is going to be one of the bigger challenges. Oftentimes, they'll have full profile roofs to be able to accommodate a full ceiling height in the very back of the RV. And often, again, because of the storage that might be underneath the actual bedroom area in the back, that full profile roof would be required. They'll typically have the largest living room areas with the most seatings in the living room itself. And this is going to be the same with rear living room floor plans with the front bedroom. So basically the mid-kitchen style as well. So I'm kind of mixing and matching these two, kind of like the Van Lee Beacon that we had for a while. Some of the longer floor plans are going to have a half bath option off of the kitchen and even a laundry center. So those are some really good perks of front living room floor plans. Now, some challenges you may have with a front living room style unit is sometimes the rooms feel a bit too disconnected. Oftentimes, there's dividers between the rooms, and if you have somebody in the kitchen, they're usually at a lower level, and you really can't have this cohesive feeling. The dinette area is typically off of the kitchen, and it's not even part of the living room space, so it can kind of feel like you're disconnected from people who are in other rooms. And you want to keep in mind that these are often going to be the largest and heaviest non-toy hauler style fifth wheels, so you definitely want to know that you have the right truck to tow something of this length and weight. Now, weight management can sometimes be difficult simply because of the storage locations and where they have to place the appliances and some of the holding tanks, especially if you have a rear bathroom unit, which is likely going to have extra gray tanks for the back area and extra plumbing to get the black tanks to where they need to be. Another thing too is in extremely hot climates, they can be difficult to cool well, especially if they only have two AC units. Having isolated spaces makes each one of the ACs a little bit less effective if you only have two units, because you have to duct air into those areas that traditionally would, you know, be an air-conditioned space in other floor plans. And finally, you're typically not going to find a front living room floor plan with your lighter, shorter manufacturers. It's usually going to be on your longer, taller, heavier units. And when I say that, it's not that they don't exist, it's just that it might be harder to find. Okay, now let's talk about the mid-living room rear kitchen floor plan. Now, this is a more popular floor plan in the last couple of years. A lot of manufacturers are turning them out. It's basically a front bedroom mid-living room, and then the kitchen is towards the back. And it's kind of the reverse of a rear living room floor plan, except they do things a little bit different. Now, these are typically going to provide you the largest kitchen with the tallest ceilings, simply because anytime you put anything towards the back of the RV, it gives the manufacturers a little bit more flexibility on how they can build what they put in that space. Oftentimes, the kitchen will also have the best view in the house because it will be pointing at whatever you're backed up to, and you can have a really, really great view out of the windows and a lot of light coming into the kitchen. They'll often have quite a bit of living room space because of the opposing slides in the center as well. So just like the front living room model, you'll have those opposing slides, and typically they can put a love seat or they can put a sofa or something else that is across from another one and give you the ability to fold them out. Just keep in mind, when you fold them out, you're probably going to limit access to the kitchen or to the bedroom on each side of it. Plus, you're going to have larger basement storage areas, typically in the elevated front area or even in the back, because it gives you the ability to put storage either under the kitchen or storage under the bath deck at the front of the RV, typical to a rear living room model. Now, some of the things that you may not like about these floor plans is that they're kind of hard to balance from the manufacturing perspective, simply because most of your heavier appliances, like your refrigerator and things like that, will be placed towards the back of the unit. And the tanks for the kitchen and things like that will also be towards the back. So they have to put more effort into making sure that the design allows them to balance a unit out well. Also, seating in the living room area can sometimes feel cramped and too close to the TV, especially if the slides are like right there, because when the slides are placed close to the center, that means they're often going to be close to the entertainment center, and that can really make it kind of a hard angle to view around. And in some cases, you really can't even see around the slide wall itself, simply because it blocks your view. Generally, these are going to be your longer, heavier units as well. So typically, it will be about the same length as a front living room model or a very long rear living room model. And that is mainly because each room is kind of isolated from each other as well. So you will sometimes find that cohesive living room kitchen area on these, but sometimes they separate that space and they make an elevated rear deck where the kitchen is, and it creates that same kind of barrier that you get between the front living room models and the kitchen. So just keep that in mind. And then finally, your mid-living room rear kitchen models will typically only have one bathroom with no option to have half a bath. Now, there may be some floor plans out there that give you half a bath, but typically this floor plan is only going to have one bathroom as the only option with no half bath. Again, I don't know what brands actually have a half bath option with a mid-living room rear kitchen. If you run across one, please let me know in the comments below. And now we're going to talk about the two types of bunkhouse floor plans, the mid-bunkhouse and the rear bunkhouse. But let's first start with the mid-bunkhouse. First of all, they offer a lot of the benefits of a rear living room floor plan, basically the first one that I spoke about, but with the addition of a separate mid-room. You can oftentimes use it as a bedroom, a multi-purpose room, an office, a studio. I mean, mid-bunks just have a ton of flexibility with that center room. I've seen some people who have actually converted them into just extra storage where they keep their bikes or they keep, you know, some type of a toy that they just want out of the way. So mid-bunks can provide a lot of flexibility, even if you don't have children that are going to be sleeping in it. Also, you can generally sleep a lot of people in these units. Typically, a mid-bunk is going to have a loft above it. Not all of them, but most of them do. So you'll have the rear living room sofa that can typically sleep two people, the bunkhouse that can usually sleep three people, the loft that can sleep two people, and a bedroom that can sleep two people. So nine people inside of a mid-bunk unit is not unheard of. So that's really nice. It's easier to cool the living room and kitchen area because they tend to be slightly smaller compared to non-mid-bunk rear living room floor plans. But keep in mind, that can also affect how you cool the mid-bunk, which I'll talk about in a second. These units are also typically easier to balance for the RV manufacturer, simply because all your plumbing and everything is right in the center and you don't really have anything towards the back or towards the front, which is really nice. Now, some of the things that you may not like about a mid-bunk is the mid-bunk space itself is often hard to cool, and manufacturers try to think of innovative ways to get air ducted into that space, but typically, even though they can do it, there's not a lot of cool air that can be ducted into that space. So that room might be a little warmer than the others, especially if you don't have like the door open. So just keep that in mind. They're also typically going to be longer RVs, usually around 40 feet or more, with the exception of a few floor plans from certain manufacturers. Typically, the loft is going to have an awkward ladder system to access it, and it's going to be pretty high off the ground, except for, I think, only one brand. I think the Cedar Creek Silverback is about the only manufacturer that uses a stairway system to get up there versus an awkward ladder. And some mid-bunks may have smaller bathrooms simply to limit the overall length of the RV, so you don't see that in a lot of them, and the bathroom typically is about the same as the rear living room version of the floor plan, but just expect that some units may have a smaller bathroom just so they don't have to make the unit so long. And then finally, most mid-bunk units tend to, again, be longer but also a bit heavier than units that aren't mid-bunk. So if you're looking for a mid-bunk, just keep in mind that you're probably going to want to make sure you have a truck specifically able to tow that size, weight, and length of fifth wheel. Okay, so the last floor plan we're going to talk about is the rear bunkhouse unit. These typically are most popular amongst families, especially with more than one child, or sometimes even with one child. They will usually sleep the most people. Some floor plans can sleep up to 11 people or more, and that's specifically with units that have a loft. If they don't have a loft, it's usually going to be closer to like 9 people, similar to a mid-bunk. They're usually going to have the largest separate room for guests, so that bunkhouse itself at the end is typically going to be the largest bunkhouse you can get on an RV. Sometimes they'll have a half bathroom or even a full bathroom in that specific bunkhouse space, which is really nice. And these units are certainly better for families with lots of children. If you have 3 or 4 children, a rear bunkhouse unit is probably all you're looking at to accommodate them. Bunkhouse sizes often force the kitchen and living room area to be smaller and a bit more awkward at times, giving you more of that toy hauler feel to it, where you have like an awkward placement of the couch or you have a smaller love seat and you really don't have seating accommodation for a larger family. Some of them don't have dinettes, but a lot of them do have dinettes and they simply put a smaller sofa in that space. But again, when you have a large bunkhouse, it's going to limit where you can put some of the other things, and your kitchen and your living room tend to be the two spaces that suffer the most. Oftentimes, it's also going to limit the size of the master bedroom, simply because the way they have to change and position the bed might be more in line with a toy hauler with a large garage, simply because in some of these rear bunkhouse units, the bunkhouse would be the equivalent of a garage on a toy hauler. They also tend to be longer and heavier units. Not all the time, but many times they will be your longer, heavier units because of that extra space that they have to accommodate, and that most of the time they're going to have a full profile roof in the back. They can also be difficult to weight and balance, especially if they have a separate bathroom in the back, because the holding tanks might kind of make the weight and balancing process a little bit more awkward. So you do want to make sure that you select a truck that's capable of towing a fifth wheel that tends to be tall, long, and relatively heavy. And generally, this is something that's not typically as important, but something you may want to think about is a rear bunkhouse floor plan isn't often available from your higher-end luxury manufacturers. You don't typically see them from brands like DRV or Lux or, you know, some of your higher-end, more expensive brands that tend to really focus on full-time living couples that are looking for more of a luxurious interior. And I think that this is kind of a miss in the RV industry. I feel that a lot of folks with families, especially larger families, still want to have that same level of luxury that you might get in a DRV or a Lux, but to be able to have that in a rear bunkhouse style floor plan. So that's it. That's essentially my comparison of the most popular and common type of floor plans that you might be looking at. Keep in mind, you may find a floor plan from a certain manufacturer that bridges the gaps between these different various floor plans. You might find the ideal rear bunkhouse type floor plan or mid-living room floor plan that's ideal for your family and has some perks that I didn't go over or some features that might actually stand out about that brand that make it closer in line with perhaps another type of floor plan. And again, I can't focus on all of them because there are hundreds of floor plans that are out there. These just tend to be the most common and what you've likely been seeing when you go out on an RV dealership lot. Anyways, I'd love for you to put a comment below and kind of let me know what you've seen, some of the things that you like about certain types of floor plans and why you favor one over another. I think that would be a really great conversation. Anyways, I sure hope you enjoyed this video. If you haven't had a chance, please take a moment, subscribe to my channel, give me a thumbs up, and we will talk to you again very soon.